ओके, वेलकम टू एबी एस्ट्रोलॉजी. आप सब लोगों का स्वागत है. टुडे आई गोना डू द इंट्रोडक्शन इन टू पार्ट्स, एक्चुअली वन इन इंग्लिश एंड वन इन हिंदी. अदरवाइज द फुल वीडियो गोना बी इन इंग्लिश. सो आई रियली अपोलोजाइज फॉर द इंडियन ऑडियंस, दोज हु ऑलवेज आस्क मी दैट कैन यू मेक द वीडियो इन हिंदी एज वेल. सो मे बी इन फ्यूचर वी कैन डू दैट, बट टुडे आई हैव अ वेरी स्पेशल गेस्ट ऑन माई चैनल. ही इज द He's the first guest, I would say, the most humble person I have met. And I'm so happy to Lord Krishna that through him, that he came into my life last year. And each and every day, I try to buzz him. I try to bother him as best I could. And he's always there to help me with any information I want. So it's a very big opportunity for me, for my channel, that he's here. And so I welcome Babaji ji on my channel. Swagat hai Babaji ji aapka.
Thank you channel pe. Thank you so much for inviting, and I will be delighted to see your questions, and we can have a discussion, and we will start as soon as you finish the second introduction.
देखिए, सेकंड इंट्रोडक्शन मेरा हिंदी में है, मेरे भाइयों बहनों के लिए जो भारत में रहते हैं या जहां भी देश स्वदेश में जहां भी रहते हैं. मेरे लिए बड़ा बहुत बड़ा सौभाग्य है कि आज बाबा जीत जी मेरे चैनल पे आए. इनको मैं पिछले साल मिला था जर्मनी में, और मेरा दिल रोम रोम प्रसन्न होता है कि जब भी मैं इनसे बात करता हूँ, क्योंकि मुझे इतना, हालांकि मेरे से उम्र में ये छोटे हैं, पर मुझे इतना ज्ञान देते हैं. और इस पे तो मैंने एक वीडियो भी बनाई है कि नाम का असर आदमी की पर्सनैलिटी पे कैसे आता है. तो बाबा जी अक्सर हम अपने भारत में भी ये कहते हैं कि बाबा जी उसको कहा जाता है जिसमें विजडम होती है. तो ये क्लियर कट साक्षात एग्जाम्पल है मेरे सामने. बाबा जी जी स्वागत है आपका मेरे चैनल में. एंड फॉर द इंग्लिश ऑडियंस, फॉर द वेस्टर्न ऑडियंस, व्हाट आई वाज सेइंग वाज द हाउ द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द नेम कम्स टू देयर कैरेक्टर. एंड आई हैव आल्सो मेड द वीडियो इन माय प्लेलिस्ट दैट वी शुड बी वेरी केयरफुल व्हेनेवर वी चूज द नेम, ईदर फॉर द अपकमिंग जनरेशन और फॉर द कंपनी. इट हैज अ लॉट ऑफ इम्पोर्टेंस. And that's what I have learned from my teachers, from my gurus, from my elders. And Baba Ji, from exotic astrology, he needs no introduction. As soon as you type exotic astrology or Baba Ji, he's all over the place. So it's my very big honor that he's my first guest. And today he has come to enlighten us with his spiritual thoughts, because I have few questions for him, because I have seen mostly people don't ask or don't go into detail for those questions. So welcome Babaji ji, welcome to AB Astrology, and please, the stage is all yours and it is always yours.
Yeah, so before you sneak through the questions, I would like to say something that we met last year in Berlin.
Yes.
And we had amazing discussions, and we also did a recording some time back.
Yes, I was glad to be on your channel.
Yeah, and now as your channel is growing, and you have also given so many interviews in big channels, so...
It is all the blessings of my elders. And let me tell the audience, the tip I got, which was a very important tip in my life, Baba Ji told me that you should open. He was one of the person, other than my own teacher, Dr. Arjun Pai, that you should open up your own channel. So Baba Ji was one of those person who told me if you should, and you should open it on a Rohini day. I still remember. And everybody knows, those who know Baba Ji, those who know exotic astrology, that he's a big devotee, disciple of Lord Krishna. And who does not love Lord Krishna? Everybody does. So I'm very happy to have you.
Yes. So You can say the questions which you have, because it's a secret from
yes.
So let me also hear your questions.
Yes, I have write it down before I forget. So the first question is, Babaji,
surprise test for me today.
No. I think I have a very blind faith on you, that you are a kind of a person who will do, I think, very good justice to all these questions. And it's we are not doing an interview here. It's a very informal environment we have. I want to create. So, and I'm pretty sure you're going to give us a very good justice to all these questions.
I will try my best.
Yes. So the first question is, Babaji ji, how we can take the advantage of Jyotish in today's world? Very simple. How we can, especially even for those who does not know much about Jyotish, or those who are on a basic level, how important the Jyotish is in today's world, and how we can take the advantage of that. That is my first question. So the second question is, and on which you have also made the beautiful video, I think day before yesterday, how we can change our destiny, and can we change our destiny? Can remedies change our destiny? This is the question I also get very often, even in my consultation or in my friend circle, very common. So I think you can do very well on this as well. Third question is, do we have any free will? People ask me that, do this with your free will, or even I say someone, use your free will on top of everything. So how much free will we have, and how we can change it? Can we change it, something with our free will? So that's my third question. Fourth question, even though I have a list, but I will only ask four or five. The fourth question is, I really want you to talk about the prarabdh karmas. Because we all know that everyone says that they are fixed, we cannot change it. So I really want your insights about the prarabdh karma. What are prarabdh karmas, and from where we can see the prarabdh karmas in the natal chart? And the last question for today would be, what, because I know you, as soon as I hear about Babaji or exotic astrology, shlokas come to my mind. So it's just like calling Amitabh Bachchan and say that you have to go without saying a dawn dialogue or a shensha dialogue. So if you are here on my channel, we have to talk about shlokas. We have to give importance on shlokas, how important the mantras are. And I think in the hierarchy system of astrology, not many people give more importance to the mantras and shlokas. So I really want your insights on that as well. So these are the five questions I have. Before I forget, please take the stage and enlighten us.
Yeah, so thank you very much for inviting me once again. And can you just repeat your first question?
First question was, how we can take the advantage of Jyotish in today's world, or in today's mundane world?
Yeah, so for this, we may be thinking that, you know, we have to learn predictive astrology, or we have to learn astrology in detail, you know, then we can help others. You know, we need to know the Navamsa, we need divisional charts, we need this and that. But the good news is you don't need any of these.
Perfect.
No astrological knowledge is required for this. The only thing that we need is a good behavior.
Right.
Because nobody will stay with us if our behavior is not good with them.
Right. Okay.
Now, of course, people come to astrology for different reasons. But there are many people who say that, you know, oh, I don't want astrology, or I don't need astrology. Okay.
Right.
Why should I go to astrologers? You know, I will build my own empire. You know, karlo dunya mukti mein. Everything in your hands. You don't have to believe on the stars. This is nonsense. Going to astrologers makes you weak. Okay, this is like saying only sick people go to doctors, right?
Yes.
And my guru used to say that everybody in this world become sick some point of their life. Okay.
Yes.
Everybody will become sick one day. But anyways, the point here is, most of the times why astrology does not get into the hearts of people, you know, it gets into the head but not into the heart. Because primarily of two reasons. The first reason is, and if we reverse these reasons, then we can answer your question. Okay. So the first reason is that people don't know the ultimate purpose of astrology. The problem is most of the people think that it is just meant for some predictions, right?
Predictions, future predictions.
Yeah. So if you talk of predictions, then I was in Bonn, Germany, and one of my school friends, he is doing master's here. Okay.
Okay.
So in fact, he's also a very big non-believer of astrology. Okay. So he told me there is something called as a future paradox. Okay.
Okay.
Future paradox, there are many kinds of future paradox. The paradox which he meant was that, suppose I tell you that tomorrow you are going to lose 500 rupees, okay, or 100 euros. Then the thing is, then now I will do everything to, you know, preserve that 500 rupees. Yes?
Yes.
So then I will behave in a way that it does not happen. Okay, that I do not lose that money. But how is it possible? Because you have already gone to the future and you have seen it. That means I have already lost, right? So then what's this paradox, you know?
Yeah.
The thing is that we can grab people into all these complications by, you know, trying to tell people astrology is prediction, you know, oh, look. You will be very aware of this when you go to pages of many astrologers, you know, YouTube pages or Facebook pages, and there's nothing wrong with this, but you will always see they will have screenshots or snapshots of WhatsApp or Facebook Messenger where they will be some client or some relative or some friend will be telling them, oh wow, you predicted I will get a job July this year, I got it, you know, your prediction was right. You will see it in every channel of astrology. Okay. So what has happened is everybody has made it into a fortune telling science. And that is why many people argue that, why should I know my future? That will anyways happen, and that's a very logical argument. Why should I pay 1 rupee or 1 USD to know something which is already going to happen to me anyways without paying anything, right? Why should I waste my money?
Right.
And that is such a valid argument. Even, in fact, I will also never book a consultation with an astrologer just to see my future. I mean, that's so stupid, because you know that either you book it or you don't, it is going to come and you can't change it. Okay. So the thing is, we have to understand that it is, what is Jyotish? It is a Vedanga basically. Okay. There are two things. One is Vedanga and another is Vedanta.
Vedanta, yes.
Yes. Yep. Vedanga is, it's like Anga means part, okay, in layman's terms. So Jyotish is a Vedanga, which means it is like a part of the Vedas, okay. So anybody who claims that he knows Vedic knowledge without the knowledge of the Veda, without Jyotish, actually is not knowing the full part of the Vedanga, okay. Now it does not mean that you must know Jyotish, it's not mandatory, but if you know, it's good because you can help yourself and everybody else, okay. And the other one is Vedanta. Okay. Anta means the end.
Right.
Okay. So Vedanta means the end of the Vedas. You know, and Vedanta Sutra is there. It is written by the great sage Maharishi Vyas. And in Vedanta Sutra, he gives so many sutras. You know, sutras are like, you know, short, small missiles. You know.
Right.
So there he says, you know, that Raso Vaisaha. He says that God is the source of all pleasure. Ultimate source of all pleasure. And the word, the name, the meaning of the word Ram itself means the source of all pleasure. Okay.
Yeah.
And Srimad Bhagavatam is a natural commentary to the Vedanta Sutra. Okay. So what is the commentary? So for example, if I tell you that, oh, I have written a book, you know, 10 pages. But you say, sir, I don't understand what you have written. So then what I do? I write another book. where I don't explain point wise that okay, in page number one this is there, but I explain it in a way that you ultimately understand what is written in the Vedanta Sutra.
Right.
Okay. So it is a natural commentary to the Vedanta Sutra, which is Srimad Bhagavatam. So Vedanta is there, and then there is Vedanga. Okay, so whoever is studying Vedanga must also study Vedanta, because otherwise your study is useless, because you don't know Vedanta.
Right.
Where is the end? What are you doing? Where are you going? You're just roaming headlessly. There's no conclusion, you see. That's why people say, oh, his Saturn got activated, Jupiter got activated, and the person leaves after the consultation.
Yeah.
So, hua kya at the end? The result is, you know, phalena viparichyata. It's like shunya. There's no result there. Okay. Okay, right. I say tomorrow, next month you get a job. You will anyways get.
Yeah.
So, the point is, these two things, when we know Vedanta and Vedanga. Okay, there are many experts in astrology. I know people who can predict the day and the hour of your marriage. Wednesday, next month, next week, at 12:28, you will put the Mangal Sutra. Yes?
Yeah.
These kind of things you can predict. But the thing is that person will anyways get married that time, right?
Right.
Either you predict the day or the hour or the minute. Okay. But does he know what is marriage? Does he know what does it mean to activate the Navamsa, marriage, you know? What actually Navamsa, Dharmamsa, that's what Navamsa is, okay?
Yeah.
So, when we learn Vedanga with Vedanta, then we will understand the holistic picture of what astrology is actually, okay? So, then only we can help people. Otherwise, predictions will not save anybody. No prediction can save anybody. Yeah. Because they are just timelines of some events which will happen. Okay, predictions can never benefit anybody, no person. Because ultimately, suppose you predict the person that you should become a teacher, he will anyways become a teacher. Even if you did not predict, his life events will happen in a way, you know, he will start doing PhD, postdoc, and he will end up in teaching ultimately.
Right.
So that is the first thing. And the second thing is that we have to become very good individuals ourselves, okay?
Yeah.
Because which is the house of astrology ultimately? Which house? People
eighth
say
house.
It is the eighth house, okay? But what people don't understand is eighth house is the house where you look for divinity, but you don't find it there. That's not the house where you find divinity.
That's ninth house.
The gain of the eighth house.
Yeah.